And Billionaire Charlie, man, y'all back at it again, back with the news and with the stories. We with it, man. Listen, man, I got no wonderful and amazing programs out there for y'all, man. If y'all need assistance or guidance for the beer to make $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 a month, you know what I'm saying? I got the programs that will help you. All you have to do is email me at BillionaireCharlie16, you know what I mean, at Gmail, and I will get you information and guide you to the process. Also, people that's trying to lose weight, I have programs for you too. You know what I'm saying? If you're trying to burn down some of the weight, like me, I use the alkaline diet a lot. And I have other programs that will help you and guide you into the right path. I want you to email me at BillionaireCharlie16 for any questions and stuff like that. I will give you breakdowns and everything that you need. I'm trying to help you. I'm going to provide great information for you. And also on my links, I have some great products for you and Amazon. Like I always tell y'all, man, we are family on this channel, man. We got respect for one another, and we trying to progress each and every moment. But we're going to get into this. Jay-Z, Megan Thee Stallion, Jay Prince, and Crawford. You know what I'm saying? People, everybody out here want to talk about it, man. And did y'all know? Somebody got their chain snatched. It's crazy out here in these streets. You better watch out, okay? You better watch out. You know what I mean? For real, man. Everybody want to know my opinion on the situation out there, man, and how I feel about the thing like that. Well, to be honest, man, this is the thing I always say about business, man. You never really know who is going to stay with you to the end and who's going to turn their back on you. You know what I'm saying? Like, when we look at Nicki Minaj and her whole story and all the people, Deb, and you know what I mean, all the people she left in the dust and didn't let them know what kind of a contract she was signing or what agreement she was doing. She was doing things behind people back, and that's the music business. You feel what I'm saying? And I feel like Jay Prince was standing on his 2 feet and just saying, like, Crawford, the one that brought Megan Thee Stallion out, man, he invested into her and making her a great and big star. And he's trying to make sure he get the credit and it's just due. Because now she's standing by Jay-Z. Once you stand by Jay-Z, that's a stamp that, you know what I mean, she's official. This is all good. It's a go right here. You know what I'm saying? She signed with Roc Nation management deals and being able to get her better situations and stuff of that nature. My whole thing with this whole process, man, evidently it was offensive to Crawford or Jay Prince, because he actually came out and made a statement about it. And what he was saying, you know what I mean, when he come out in the front with this whole situation going on, you know it connected something behind the scenes that's saying, like, he felt like it was a violation. Now, a conversation may have happened that may have smoothed things over, and he went back into the public eye and let the people know that it ain't that serious. But when the first statement came out, anybody with logical sense or any type of sense understood that it was a problem that had happened. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing that would happen with Lil Wayne and Birdman when he went over there to try to do the Roc Nation thing over there. So like I always tell people, man, it's business, man, and it's never personal. And that's how they look at it. Jay-Z and all the other people that's signing people and doing deals of that form or fashion, they look at it from a business standpoint. It's not personal relationships. That's how they look at it. So when they do stuff like that and take an artist, it's not their fault that their artists want to sign with Jay-Z and be a part of Roc Nation. It's the popular thing to do right now. You know what I mean? If you're not signing with Jay-Z, who you signing with? Meek Mill, everybody and their mama and daddy over there with Roc Nation. You know what I'm saying? So they want a better situation, better venues, and great opportunity to make some big money in their career and be able to be established all the way. You know what I'm saying? Now, every artist is not going to take the Roc Nation deal, but right now, that's the popular thing to do within the hip-hop community, is to go over there, sign with Roc Nation, take a picture with Jay-Z. Now you established. You know what I'm saying? Even though you probably was established before the actual picture and things of that nature. But like I say, man, when Jay Prince opened his mouth and when he wrote that stuff that he wrote, it came from somewhere, you know what I mean? So we're not going to front on this camera or front in front of anybody and try to make it seem like it didn't come from somewhere. It was a feeling that somebody was feeling, either him or the guy Crawford that was with him. They felt some type of way about the whole situation, because I feel like when you stand next to Jay, it shadow out everybody else that was a part of the process. Now, he's not being mentioned at all. Megan Thee Stallion didn't mention him at all. So, evidently, it was some type of conflict in the relationship. And then what happens is, when it all goes into the media and everybody talking about it, people start to backtrack. And when people backtrack, they try to make it seem like it was never nothing. But we all know what human knowledge and are able to have her ability to think outside of the box and understand that this was something different. No man would get like with the power of Jay Prince would come out and just say a statement like that, and it means absolutely nothing. When the last time you heard Jay Prince say something that didn't mean anything? You feel what I'm saying? Even with the chain being snatched to the young boy, you know what I'm saying? When he said what he said, he meant that. And he meant what he said last time. Like I said, him and Jay probably got on the phone and had a conversation. I doubt it ever happened that he had a conversation with Jay. I doubt it very seriously, because there's not too many people that actually say they had conversations with Jay on a regular. But if he did have a conversation with Jay, that's probably why he kind of like giving him the benefit of the doubt. But he also wanted to let the guy that was from his neighborhood be known for his record label from finding Megan Thee Stallion, establishing her as a brand and as a great and amazing music artist. And he wanted him to be known and be respected in that point. If Megan Thee Stallion ain't going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like I told you before, within that music business is a lot of triflingness, man. For years, Cash Money. They still, like Jay Prince and them, was still waiting for that money from Birdman from bringing them Drake. You know what I'm saying? Jay Prince son from bringing them Drake. He did a lot of funny business. Even with T-Pain, man. They had a situation with T-Pain. T-Pain was even coming on record saying a lot of times he wasn't getting paid for doing stuff with Wayne. And Rick Ross came out about the DJ Khaled and stuff. Why you think? So now when you look around and you pay attention, right, you notice that DJ Khaled is now trying to be closer to Jay, not closer to Birdman, you know, because of the money situation. You feel what I'm saying? Like the music business can be trifling at times. And it just shows you, like, can you really trust people in the business? Because like, this is the end of the day, man. Everybody's trying to do what's best for them, and that was best for you. So you got a company or you got a brand, and you making an artist, and you break them, and they become this big-time superstar. Is they still going to love you when they on top? And a lot of people don't have that loyalty to still love the people that helped them from the beginning. Like, I told this story before, man. You have a person go to jail, you put money on their books, you look out for them. And that same dude that you was riding for, your homie, he'll go chill with a bunch of guys that wouldn't give a dollar to him. Because people, you would think after you get out of high school and stuff like that, that popularity or in crowd thing would be over. But it really is not. You know what I'm saying? People are still looking for validation in life. You know what I'm saying? They're still searching for it. You know what I'm saying? No matter how much money they get and things. Why you think about this, right? Look at Nicki Minaj, man. Nicki Minaj is an established artist. She done had so many top number ones and so many great album sales, but she still feel empty inside. Because now it's Megan Thee Stallion. Now it's Cardi B. Now it's all these different artists that are coming up and they're becoming bigger brands than her. You know what I'm saying? Megan Thee Stallion have a chance to actually be an opportunity to be bigger than even Nicki Minaj by standing with Jay and being a respectable person. You feel what I'm saying? So when I look at these situations like that, it's like, this is what I'm talking. She's looking for validation from people, and she'll never get it. You got to have it upon yourself to know that I created this brand. I created myself, and I am great. I don't need the validation of a bunch of people that don't care about me. The people that do care about you, they're going to ride for her. All the barbs and stuff like that. See, she care about a people opinion that's not a barb, that's not really riding for her. And that's the problem with America, man. They made social media, right? Because so many people just desire attention, right? They dying for this, to have somebody watch them, pay attention to them. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, they ain't even getting money for none of the things that they doing. They just doing it just to do it. You know, some people run around slapping people just for attention. Just for something. You know what I'm saying? So when I come to saying all this stuff, man, you got to understand it's a crooked business and all the things that you do when it comes to entertainment, period, man. Because everybody's for self within life and within any business that you're doing stuff a lot of times. People are just for self. And I think Jay Prince just didn't like the taste. It may not even have been nothing to do with Jay-Z. It could have been all Megan Thee Stallion. Everything she had done that probably crossed the person that actually brought her up. What we all seen with Nicki Minaj did with Deb and a lot of artists that was with Deb that turned their back on Deb and just officially disrespected her in all types of ways. So that's why I always tell people, man, business period, man. You know in this world you can't really trust too many people because people be for self. You know what I'm saying? And this is what we learning and this is what we saying. So I have no problem with Jay Prince saying what he felt and his opinion and his where he stands with the situation because it make a lot of valid points of what he was standing for. You understand? So it's like, if you can't catch the wave or understand what he was talking about, then Just don't pay attention to it, because basically he's saying, why is he not getting his respect or his credibility on her pages, and why is she not shouting him out when he the one that invested in her? And I think it's a form of disrespect from her because of why she doing it like that, why she carrying it like that. You know what I mean? She can help him as well as she helped as he helped her. But like I say, everybody don't got the same integrity. You know what I'm saying? But that's what I got from that when I sent it. And I mean, everybody got their own opinion. I am a billionaire, Charlie, and I appreciate y'all experiencing this wonderful video. And like I said, if you need any help with any business right now, or you're trying to make some extra money, go to my email address, billionairecharlie16. I'm going to provide some great things for you. And when you come over there, I already have an idea what you're trying to do, from gaming, writing, or anything you're trying to do. And I'm going to provide you with the best programs, best system to help you. Also, if you're trying to lose weight, I'm going to also have a program for you. Like I said, I use the alkaline diet. I do a lot of green drinks and stuff of that nature. So if you need some help with sea moss or anything of that to keep your body clean and stuff like that, hit me up and I'm going to provide some great products for you. Matter of fact, I got some things in the link right now for you. Sea moss and great green products that help the body out, keep you right, keep you good. You understand what I'm saying? So it's all about us being a family and helping one another. And I'm going to guide y'all to the promised land. Make sure y'all email me at billionairecharlie16, because I would love to have a one-on-one conversation with the audience and with people that tune into my channel. And I want to know what you're thinking and how you're feeling. You understand? So hit me up, man. Billionaire Charlie. I love all of y'all there, and I appreciate y'all tuning in to me, man. And remember, man, I always keep my little soul crystal.
Hi, welcome to my Cinderella Solution Review. The Cinderella Solution is a weight loss program specifically designed for women. This plan enables women to drop excess pounds and live a healthy and happy lifestyle. The Shoku-Iku concept of the Japanese forms the foundation of this program. Basically, what this routine does is that it balances metabolism and hormones. By doing so, it triggers amazingly fast fat loss and also supercharges the immune system. Reviews and a solid money-back guarantee show that it is not a mere scam, but an effective program. This proven program works to balance three key hormones that maintain youth, beauty, and immunity. For serving this purpose, it uses efficient food pairings and details what not to eat. Cinderella Solution Weight Loss Guide is based on the Shoku-Iku concept. It balances the three vital hormones of the female body. These are insulin, cortisol, and estrogen.
I wanted to share a product that I've actually been ending my evenings with, and that is the Organifi Gold Juice. This product is awesome, and it contains some ingredients that are sort of going to relax you and basically promote a deeper sleep. So they've got reishi mushroom in there, turmeric, magnesium, lemon balm, turkey tail, and what I've actually been doing is just getting a scoop. So it looks like this. I put a scoop into my mug. I fill the mug pretty much to the top with hot, like warm water or like hot water. And then I like to put a splash of almond milk in there. Then I like to froth it up. And when you froth it up, it turns into this really awesome, like golden milk, delicious drink that you can just sip on before you sleep. And Organifi is actually a really cool company. They've got red juice and green juice as well for certain things. So I definitely urge you guys to check them out. And yeah, hopefully you enjoy it. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.